All right, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I have Miss Karen Staley.
That's it.
Get it right that time.
Yay. Thanks, Ray. And I want to thank my friend Tim Hall, too, for asking me. He's a hometown boy. So, I'll have been in Nashville in October 40 years. Can't believe it. I came here when I was an embryo. And so I've been very fortunate, and I'm going to do some songs for you now. So people ask us where we get the ideas to keep writing songs. And I was writing with a friend of mine one day, and we couldn't think of anything to write about. So he was going through a divorce, and we started talking about dating and having to date again, and, you know, gaining weight and him losing hair. And we couldn't think of anything to write about, so we went to this little place called Bongo Java to have some lunch. And I went into the restroom, and there's all this graffiti all over the wall in the stalls, and it said, "Beauty is only a light switch away." And we thought that was hilarious. We came back and ironically wrote this song for Faith Hill, who looks good in any light, I'm sure. Iconic songwriters called me up, a guy named Dickie Lee. He wrote "She Thinks I Still Care" for George Jones, and Patches, remember that? Patches, "I'm Depending on You, Son." He had his own career stuff in the 60s too, just a magnificent guy. And another guy named Danny Bear Mayo, who wrote a bunch of stuff for Confederate Railroad, "Feed Jake," and just a great guy. And they didn't need me to help with the song, but I'm sure glad they allowed me to. So when I bought it 10 years ago. There you go. And so I was very fortunate to have this. It's like she said, it was a big wedding song and a lot of Is it hotter in here or is it your career, Tim? It's so hot I heard Dolly Parton was selling shade. care because... Sorry. As close as it's gonna get.
It was no accident.
Thank you.
Me finding you. Someone had a hand in it long before we ever knew. Now I just can't believe you're in my life. Heaven's smiling down on me, and as I look at you tonight,
great sound, and he got it going on, so thank you. I can just relax and sing.
Well, Miss Karen, I do have a quick question.
Yeah, you got it.
Since you've been in the industry for so long, and I won't go into details on how long, but what advice would you give to some of these up-and-coming songwriters that are out here today?
I would say there's a fine line between writing for the radio and staying true to yourself. Because the only way you're really going to cut through is to be totally unique. Now, the minute you're a hit, then they'll sign 12 of you right after that. But the goal is to be the first person. Then you'll have a long career. And I think that's the main thing. And just my thing is, I think a lot of people don't do now, is read. It just helps you so much with getting a command of the language. We're all just so used to... texting everything. In fact, when I write, I still write with a pen and a paper, and then I type it into my laptop after that, but there's just something about just going straight from my brain out my hand that, I don't know, to me makes a difference. I don't know, some people. I know you can chat GP it if you want to, but I mean, I literally, this is how old school I am, because I'm not superstitious necessarily. I just, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I write the alphabet across the top of the page. I don't even use like all the programs and stuff for songwriting and all that. You can. And I like all the stuff that's on the radio. Unlike some of my peers who are like, oh, I need kids nowadays. Well, there's always been kids nowadays. Elvis was a kid nowadays. You know, there's this great stuff, and everything doesn't have to be Shakespeare. I mean, my song, Hey Baby, Let's Go to Vegas, I read in 45 minutes as a goof. And, you know, the Beatles had I Want to Hold Your Hand. This is not Shakespeare. Music has a lot of purposes. Just for fun, it can be, you know, make you think, make you dance, make you cry, whatever. So I try not to me, I never, like, if I have to do song contests or whatever, I never say if it's a good or a bad song. That's in the, as I say, the ear of the beer holder. But but I can tell you what's commercial. That's all I can tell you is. But, and then, actually, here, I'm going to do an audible since you thought that song. This is a song that hasn't had a hit yet. But I think if I could say this to anybody, not even just about the music business, but anything else, it's like, especially when you're my age, you can look back and the things that hurt you the most when you go to sleep are the things that you didn't do. You can get over the stupid stuff you did, but the opportunities that you missed out of fear or not thinking you're good enough or whatever, you can't get back. And so, this was sort of inspired by that. And then my mother, who was a just consummate worrier, we would go someplace like and be driving and I'd say, we need to get a hotel. And she goes, but what if they don't have any rooms? And I'd go, but what if they do? Got my first guitar at 12 years old. That's when everything in my world changed. Started writing down my feelings into song, dreaming about being on stage. Some people cheered me on and they sang along, but some people filled my head with doubt. Said you could find something to fall back on in case your dreams don't pan out. What if they do? What if I fly? Will it hurt to go for the gold? I don't want to wonder what if when I'm old. What if the planets all align? I'll shoot for the moon, but the stars will be fine. Not a single one of them may come true. But what if they do? What if they do? When the world gets tough, they said anything's possible if you believe and work hard enough. But you gotta want it, gotta sacrifice. Won't just fall in your hands. Give it all or nothing. 110 things might not work out like you planned. What if they do? What if I? What'll it hurt to go for the gold? Don't wanna wonder what if when I'm old. What if the planets all align? I'll shoot for the moon, but the stars will be fine. Not a single one of them may come true. But what if they do? What if they do? Home runs, so. But I say, I'm sort of like a cicada. I get something every 7 or 13 years, come out of the ground, and go back in the ground. Okay, this song kind of ties into that of just never. I never had an exit plan. I don't know. Some people do, but I never did. And I'm sort of the Forrest Gump of country music, because I tell people, I just kind of, things just happened for me because I went, you want to do this? Okay. So Tim called me up last week and said, you want to do Bell Buckle? I went, okay. I love Bell Buckle. So I wrote this song in 2004. So imagine how Nashville and everything has changed since then. And so I had this horse farm in Arrington, Tennessee for a while. And then I called it Faith Hills because that's who paid for it. And so it was just amazing. And then my parents were going to come and stay with me and help me take care of it. And then my dad had a stroke and a heart attack and all that. He ended up living another 17 years, but he couldn't do all that kind of stuff. So I ended up selling it and moved into Brentwood, which most people go, ooh, Brentwood. But I'm a country girl, so it was like weird for me to move into Stepford Wives, you know. So then I ended up I sold all my horses, but there's a place called Green Pastures there. It's the last 250 green space acres in Brentwood. And they have all these horses there. Someone left a horse in a divorce. They just left it there. And so they asked me if I wanted it, and I took it. And had a great time there. It's just pasture boarding, and you know, I don't know if anybody's had horses, been around horses. They're very, just like any pet. They're just amazing. A lot of people are going through divorces and cancer and stuff like that, and just it meant so much to them. Well, then because it's so beautiful, what they got to do? They got to decide to sell it and make more McMansions. And we're like, oh, that's what the world not needs. And so I said, well, here's the deal. I said, rich people always get people wanting something from them. Let's just thank them. So I said, everybody just make a scrapbook of you and your horse, picture what it means to you to be here. And then I wrote this song, and we put a video underneath of it. And I don't know if it was the catalyst, but it was helpful, I think. And we gave it to them for Christmas, and they cried, and they never sold it. And so that was 2004. It is now 2024, and it is still the Green Pasture Farm. So the coolest part about this is you never know what's going to happen with the song. So I wrote the song in 2004 opining about how fast things were progressing in Nashville. I had no idea it would turn into what it's turned into. Some friends of mine, Daley and Vincent, they're a bluegrass band. You might have seen them there on the Opry all the time and stuff. So they sang this song out of the blue. They had friends that are in the Tennessee the Congress, the Senate, and they somehow brought it about, and so this is one of the newest Tennessee state song, official Tennessee state song, the 11th in 216 years, so so it took me, 20-some years to get this song even heard, but the full circle thing is I got to meet Governor Lee when they presented me with the song, and then he said, Green Pastures Farm, he goes, I'm going to put that in a land trust. Then people don't need no more money. So it came through 20 years later what we needed. So.
But I love this place much as anyone. My soul's going to heaven when they bury me. But I'll leave my heart in Tennessee, right? Fields stone shining like diamonds on the hills and pastures. Things round here move slow, but they're gonna get fast. Bulldozers and farms and fences in the name of progress. Damn those developers, they're cold and heartless. people. The rivers and the creeks and the colorful people. Nothing like a sunset fading low in a pink sky. Singing how great thou art with a tear in my eye. I'm just a loyal immigrant, not a native son, but I love this place much as anyone. My soul's going to heaven when they bury me, but I'll leave my heart in Tennessee.
Probably like most writers, it's one that wasn't recorded. It's called Somebody's Child. You would ask me, and I can't remember. All I can remember, all I can retain is water anymore. So, but it's like everybody's favorite. Then there's another kind of love song I have called With You that's been cut like 20 times, and like it was on Faith Hill's Breathe album until like the last hour. But how could I be pissed at Faith for taking it off after she bought me a farm? So many emotions. But and then, like I said, I got this one that I wrote for Faith that, you know, I got Shakespeare with dust on it like that. And then I get this goofy ass song cut. Excuse my French. Lay goofy ass shit. So this friend of mine had this terrible Elvis impersonation. He's always going, he's like, come on, baby. Come on, let's go to Vegas. Let's get Lisa Marie getting a good baby. So I can't, I wrote this song, like literally in 45 minutes, just jacking around. And I played it for someone. They're like, that's actually pretty cool. And I played it for my publisher. He goes, that's actually pretty cool. And I was actually out on the road playing guitar and singing with Faith at the time. And so basically I was very fortunate enough to talk her into doing it. So the best 45 minutes of my life.
Lying on the bank of the river, stars are dancing, Lord, it's hot. Holding you is what I live for. I just had a crazy thought. Hey, baby, let's go to Vegas. Kiss a single life goodbye. Hey, baby, let's go to Vegas. Bet on love and let it ride. Chapel, a pair of rings and a preacher too. Underneath the neon steeple, we'll take a gamble and say I do. Hey baby, let's go to Vegas. Kiss a single life goodbye. Hey baby, let's go to Vegas. Bet on love and let it ride.
This video, this song, because it's 24 years ago when I was kind of hot and happening, and I got to be in the video, and I had a white micro mini skirt and these thigh-high white boots and a white Telecaster I was playing, so that's pretty much a hit. Then I discovered moon pies.
Hey baby, let's go to Vegas. A kiss, a single life goodbye. Hey baby, put on love and let it ride. on love and let it ride. Bet on love and let it ride.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Lorraine, and thank you, Tim, again. Appreciate y'all.
Got one more question.
Oh, you got it. So yes, I'm having catfish. Over at the market.
Make sure you have corn nuggets, too.
Oh, yeah.
So out of all the artists that you've written for, uh-huh, you've performed with, who is your favorite? Other than Ben Faith, because, well, she bought you the ranch.
But. Yeah. I love performing with her, too. And then really the first person I went out and performed with and learned so much was Reba. This is like back in the day, sometimes you could just go in and play on guitar like a song. And so when I got to town, long story, it worked out, I could go in the office with her and play her some songs. And so I played her some songs, she didn't take any. And then I'm living in this little apartment with three other girls, and I'm country's cornbread, green as could be, never done anything in my life really. And I get this phone call, and she goes, "Hey, Karen, it's Reba." And I'm like, "Yeah, right." And I hang up. I think it's a friend of mine, like, messing around. He calls back, "No, it's really Reba. Come hang up." She goes, "What are you doing?" I said, "Eking out an existence." She goes, "You want to go on the road with me?" I went, "Okay." Never done that in my life. And I don't read music tonight, so I had to, like, go buy all her albums and stuff and, like, memorize everything, learn how to do it and everything. So, but she was awesome, and she's the kind of person that she would play for four people the same show she would play a stadium for. Work, you know, just, she is the person that you see, and I've met so many stars, I can count on one hand with three of my fingers down, who are really the people that they say are. Her and Dolly, and like, maybe a couple other people, but she is just a good person, fair person, and Faith is the same way. Just very generous, and you know, that's rare to find that kind of talent and that kind of humility in the same person. And Faith is kind of, Reba's kind of doing with the Dolly thing with her later years. She's not that old, but she's just really about giving back, and just so helpful with people. So that's what I say. Even if you just got something good happening for you, you know, just share it with somebody, you know, pay it forward to somebody. It will come back to you for sure. That's what Nashville's about. Unlike LA or New York or something like that, we're all a family, and if something great happens for someone, I mean, we're competitive, like in a good way, but if something good happens, it just makes all of us, you know, feel like we're part of it. And it makes it grow. So remember that when you guys, anytime, just give it 150%. And my other, you know, motto is, if there's nothing, if it's not meant to happen, if it's not God's plan for you, nothing you can do is going to make it happen. But if it's God's plan for you, nothing you can do to screw it up will make it not happen. So just give it your all. Don't worry about screwing up. Worry about not doing enough. Because my mentorship was, I don't know how to make you rich and famous, but I can tell you not to. I've already done it all. Thank you. All right. Thanks, Izzy. Thank you again. Thanks for listening to my ramblings.
Are you kidding? We love to hear the ramblings. It's fantastic.